Hi, this is a short video on tonguing, basic tonguing. It's really pretty easy. All you're doing is using your tongue to separate the notes. It can be the same note, it can be different notes. At first, it's probably best to start out using the same note. It's just a little easier. You can think about your tongue more instead of having to worry about changing notes. So just pick any note. I'm going to use probably a G for these exercises or these examples. When you tongue, the important thing is to keep your air moving the whole time. And what your tongue is doing is just flicking against the roof of your mouth, your teeth. It depends on where you actually decide to tongue. We'll talk about that in a second. But it's really important to keep that air moving the whole time. If you think of a hose, it's on full blast. The tongue is like the finger. When you chop through the water, you have little chunks of water, but the flow never stops. And so that's what you want with your air. You want your air to move the whole time, all the way through all of these tonguing exercises. So basically what you're doing is there's a few ways you can think about your tonguing. You can think of it by using a syllable. Two, 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 two. If you say that, basically you're doing the tonguing. Just keep the air moving. When you're actually tonguing, you're not saying any of these words or even really shaping your mouth to make the sound. It's more of the action of the tongue. So when I'm actually tonguing, instead of thinking two, 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 I'm going a small detail, but an important one. So you can think two, 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 ta, 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 ti, ti, ti. Some of those will work better, different places in the range. The best way to start out, I think, is with the two. What you do want to be careful of is you don't want your jaw to move. If you use the ta, 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 sometimes the jaw will tend to move and that could mess you up. So keep the jaw still, and it's just the tongue that's moving. Very quick, sharp movements. So I just said the two, two, two. You can also use thu, thu, thu. So if you feel where your tongue is hitting when you say thu, you can even see it. It's right on the tip of your teeth, thu, thu, thu. This will often give you a cleaner attack, a cleaner, clearer beginning to the note. Some people find this easier. I didn't learn about this way of tonguing until much after I had been playing, so I don't really use it that much, unless I need to be really precise with my entrances. But the thu, thu, thu can work, tu, tu, tu. If you're looking for a softer kind of tongue, like for jazz, do, do, do works really well too. I mean, in fact, you can try any syllable, lu, 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 you know, gu, 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 anything. Depends on what you're after. But the cleanest ways to do this are the tu, 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 or the thu, thu, thu version. And again, you want to touch your tongue for the thu right on the very tip of your teeth. For the tu, it's right where your gums and your teeth meet behind your teeth. Tu, tu, tu. If you say that, you can feel that back there. What you don't want is that. You don't want your tongue to touch the lips, which are vibrating. You don't want to stop the lip vibration. You want to just stop the air. So when you're doing this, don't. And this is pretty easy to do if you're using the thu on the back of your teeth. So just be careful of that. You should be fine. You can do this with the buzz, with the mouthpiece, whatever. When you do it with just the buzz, it'll sound something like this. With the mouthpiece. And then finally with the horn, I'm going to use just a G. Okay, so that's the basics. Practice with just one note till you can get it nice and clear and clean, and then try moving from one note to the next. You can vary the tonguing quite a bit between tonguing and slurring. For example, I've been working on my whole tone scales, and so if I just change the slurring and the tonguing around, it really adds a different variety. So I'm probably going to mess this up because these are still not really under my fingers, but I'll give it a try. So this is just like a C whole tone scale with various tonguings. Not too bad. A couple clamps in there. Anyway, you get the idea. When you finally get the basics of the tongue down, try messing around with it, doing as many different ways of using it as you can come up with. It makes it a little more fun. There's no need to buy a book necessarily to learn all that stuff. Just use your imagination and have fun with it. So hope that was helpful. Good luck.